guys I bunked with last month told me about the sounds, man. At night, on the hills, the sounds fuck with your head.
Dig it. Shit. What the fuck is that?
Shut your holes. It's nothing.
There's movement down there.
I see it too. Fuck.
Negative. You two better chill.
No, man. I see it. They're moving in.
That ain't the Mist Brothers.
Sappers!
They're like ghosts, man! Light them up! Put up, bro!
Plays tricks with my eyes.
Thank you. Jesus H. Where the hell have you pukes been? We've been getting the living shit pounded out of us.
Oh, and we haven't been.
Can it, numbnuts? One more word and I'll have you burning shit for the rest of your time in country. I want you people to take up positions in these bunkers and foxholes. Our left flank has been overrun. Reinforcements are mounting a counterattack in the morning, but we must hold this ridgeline through the night. Move up. Take another man and hop on that mule. Go down the hill and attack the left flank. There's a gap in that NVA line that we can exploit if we move on it right now. I'll round up the people for the counterattack.
There,
move out!
You're doing great. Ah!
I'll drive. Shepard's something like a good luck charm these days.
See you guys later. Hey.
Yeah, no problem, little man. I'll watch Big Brother's ass for you.
That stuff.
Yeah.
Well done. All right, people, we got one last job to do. We gotta push up this hill and take back the positions that the NVA took from us. Flush them and frag them. Shepard, you and your squad lead the way. That was your ground to hold. Now let's get it back. I will see you men at the top of the hill. Move out.
Man, he's dead. He's gone.
Oh, shit. Medic! Get a medic up here.
I need you men to put some guns in those bunkers. We've got to reinforce this hillside. Let's secure our wounded and dead until we can get them extracted.
Screw you, Dandridge.
Show some fucking respect, you asshole. This is our friend over here.
These are my men, Marine. Every damn one of them, including your friend. Your friend was incredibly brave, and his actions will be recognized. But right now, I've got to reinforce this position, so suck it up. Charlie's gonna be back, and I don't want him to catch us with our pants down.
Dear Mom and Dad, I already have a couple of letters to send off to you, so I thought I'd write you another note to let you know Jamie and I got through to fighting safely. We got counterattacked the night we were stuck out on the hills, but Jamie and I managed to get back to our lines when our foxholes were overrun. By the end of the night, the NVA had overextended themselves looking for us, and we were able to roll them up and get off the hill for good. Unfortunately, Pat Hodges didn't make it. He died up there on the hill. This death really hit us all hard. I've known Pat since elementary school, and he was always nice to me. He never cared what the other white kids thought about being friends with a black kid. I keep asking myself if there was something I could have done to save him. I know deep down that there wasn't, but it's been eating away at me. Anyway, Hoss and I will be heading home in a month. We're getting transferred to the MacV compound in the city of Wei, where we'll be stationed for the rest of our tour. Wei hadn't been attacked at all during the war, so I think the rest of my time in country will be pretty uneventful. Captain Dandridge is being transferred there as well. Greaser and Smooth have promised to keep an eye on Jamie for me, so I wouldn't worry about him. Love, Dean.